the killer. This movie is really not about revenge. It's about polishing your skills. So stick around. As I get into more details, I really have an interesting theory that you must hear. The killer, Michael Fassbender, the protagonist in the film, whose actual name is never mentioned, but uses various names throughout the film, almost Jason Bourne type of vibes. Anyway, Michael delivers a never-ending narration while he awaits to execute a kill. But when I thought about the character, like really thought about the depths of the character, it made sense. David Fincher, I hope I'm saying the name right, is the director of this film. His attention to detail throughout the movie is immaculate, as every little thing plays an important part. This is a very intelligent and smartly written movie that requires you to think, for me at least. I really liked it. This made it a fun challenge to figure out certain elements of the film, to also pay attention to the details. Plus, the movie finds a way to sort of make you feel like you're playing a video game, or like you're shadowing a real contract killer the whole time. And the main character's narration is a unique touch. Even the normal everyday things, he gives he gives us a constant look at over his shoulder, like the things that he thinks, like buying this, doing that. So that in itself is really amazing. The film has a pace that has a constant tension, with certain moments where it escalates to a rapid, venomous action. Yet the action never seems to be overdone. It feels hyper realistic in a way. Now, pay attention. I have a theory about this whole film. I feel like this is a perfect misdirection trick by the film creators. You never know this unnamed assassin. You never get to know what makes him tick the whole film. I think that's the whole point of the film. As a viewer, we normally project our moral compass onto what we're watching. We think this is a revenge story. We are rooting for this character who's fighting back because his loved ones were attacked. But I really think that's not the point. I think it's darker than we think. It's bigger than what the creators let us see. Throughout the film, the creator has sort of made that the assassin or the killer repeats his rules. He repeats them. With every kill, he repeats his rules. Sometimes he's interrupted while repeating or narrating the rules, and then he executes a kill. He never mentions anything personal about his home, about his girlfriend. To me, I feel like he doesn't care about anyone. People are not important. After all, he's just a paid killer. To me, he's basically telling us he's craving a challenge. And I believe that he subconsciously made an error by botching up the first kill. The kill that he waited days for. I feel like he messed it up intentionally, you know, on purpose, in order to liven things up, to see what would happen, to see what could push him over the edge, and so that he could, work out his abilities to the extreme. So I feel like he created an excuse to go on a killing spree around the world. And by the end, he realizes he loves his job again. And this is why he doesn't kill the client. He knows that he would destroy future gigs. And the final scene, for me that is he poisons his girlfriend's coffee. And he sits there as he waits for her to perish. Because the girlfriend is his only weakness, when you really think about it. His vulnerable target. His handlers immediately went after her after he botched the job. Now he's learned this. Now, in order to avoid this from happening again, he kills her. But then again, I could be wrong. I could be wrong. Like, it just doesn't make sense to me. Like, he really went on the hunt for them. And for me, it doesn't really... When he kills the first guy, I mean the lawyer guy, he's like, dude, you don't need to do this. You could have just taken the money and just went away, but maybe they would have found him. So who knows? So in conclusion, The Killer is a must-watch drama thriller film that combines suspense, brilliance, and a stellar performance to create an unforgettable cinematic experience. If you really appreciate well-crafted narrative that keeps you guessing until the very end, this film is a must-see for you. So, what are you waiting for? Go watch it. You won't be disappointed. Now that was entertaining. Please let us hang out yet another time. Remember to like and subscribe. Adios, folks. Adios.